Hello, hello, hello. I'm so happy to be here. I'm going to be doing a pretty quick training today that basically goes over three signs that you need to change your business name. So who is this video for? It's for the entrepreneurs out there, people who own their own businesses. And what we're going to cover are some things that are threats to your business that you may not have even thought about. So if you are out there, you're an entrepreneur, you're interested in bulletproofing your brand, keeping your brand protected, then please tune in to this video because your business name is kind of everything, right? It's a really important asset to your business. It's a really important part of your business. But for many people, they learn relatively late in the game that they end up needing to change their business name. So we're going to talk about whether or not you need to change your business name and three signs that you do. So let's just dive in. All right. So I've already gone over what we're going to talk about today, three signs that you need to change your business name. Let's talk a little bit about who I am. For those of you who are new to me, my name is Ashley Nicole Kirkwood. I'm the founder of Mobile General Counsel. I'm also a trademark and contracts lawyer. I'm also the founder of Speak Your Way to Cash and creator of some really cool DIY legal trainings, such as Get the Tea on Trademarks and Clap Back with Contracts. So if you need any of those links, just let me know. Put interested in the comments and I'll make sure to get you all those links. Hey, so that you all can have them. So just let me know if you need those links. And FYI, for those of you joining on Facebook, there are some slides that go with this, this training, and they're just informational for the most part. But if you want those slides, then after this training a little bit later today, just head over to the Mobile General Counsel Facebook page and I'll be posting this presentation with the slides there for your viewing pleasure. All right, so that's who I am. Legal background, went to Northwestern Law, undergrad, University of Illinois. So I'm Big Ten all the way. Started my career at a large firm called Kirkland & Ellis and then decided to launch my own law firm. Okay, all that's out the way. I always like to start with this, even though I've said this before about what a trademark is. And we're going to get into whether or not you need to change your business name because I know that's why a lot of you are here. But let's get some foundational stuff out the way. So a trademark is anything that separates your brand from the next brand. So the name, the slogan, the colors can be trademarked. Now, when you have a registered trademark, those folks use what's called the registration symbol. It's going to be the R with the circle around it, the R with the circle around it. If you don't have a registered trademark, so if you're watching this and you have not yet come to me or my firm to help you to register your trademark, then the symbol you should be using is just the TM symbol. And the way that I like to describe it is if you type in trademark in an iPhone, I think the TM symbol comes right up. But it's going to be the TM symbol versus the R symbol with the circle. So that just kind of describes how those things should appear. Now, if you catch somebody using the R with the circle around it, the registered symbol, and they don't have it registered, then, you know, I don't know what you can do about that outside of just letting them know they're false flagging out here, because that's what those things mean. That's what those things mean, all right? So now that we've gone over a little bit about what a trademark is, we're going to go through now, what are the three questions that you need to ask yourself? What are the three questions that you need to ask yourself to determine whether or not you need to change your business name? So that's why you guys are here. So we're going to just get right into it, okay? Number one, and if someone who's watching can just write this down, number one, is the question you want to ask is your business name original? Is your business name original? Now, what do I mean by original? It doesn't mean it has to be the most inventive name on the planet, but it needs to be unique to you. It needs to be something that not only did you think of, but it is novel in some sense. And why do I say that? Because the easiest names to get registered, those names that are going to be the simplest to go through the trademark process, are those names that are unique, those names that are original. Some people, I've had some really cool business owners that have worked with me and they've done things like combine the first two letters of all their children's name, or they've combined three or four words that actually represent their brand really well. So the names are really original. And you want to ask specifically, did you invent one of the terms in your business name? Did you invent one of the terms in your business name? So did you, if you can look up, and here's how you answer this question, I'm gonna make it real plain. Can you look up every single word that you utilize in your business name in the dictionary? If no, then maybe you invented one of those words and that's totally fine. So did you invent one of those names? Now, do you have to do something like that? No, because the trademark registrar has what's called the principal registrar and the supplemental registrar. So if your name is just descriptive, meaning it's not original at all, it basically just describes the goods that you're serving or servicing, then maybe, you know, maybe you can get registration on the supplemental registrar, but we always want to shoot for the principal registrar first. So is your business name original? And be honest, if you sell bundles and the name of your company is like bundles, I'm sorry, everyone doesn't know what that means. If you sell hair extensions, right? And the name of your company is like Bundles Galore, is it original? I don't know. I mean, there may be another company that already utilizes Bundles and Galore already. You need to look it up. You need to see if it's inventive. Is it unique? And here's the other thing, guys. You can be copying someone else's business name even if you didn't know about their business. Because I hear this all the time. It's like, oh, no. Now y'all know I just ate my lunch. I hear this all the time. It's like, oh, no, I didn't copy her name. I didn't know anything about that company. I always get that call. I got a cease and desist and I know nothing about that company. That is not the standard. The standard is you may have to change your business name if someone else who already has the registration for that trademark has registered their name first. So it's all about first in time. So a lot of business owners wait. They wait and they're like, I'm gonna just wait to get a trademark because I'm so small right now. But really that's a lack of faith. And I'm gonna tell you, I did something like that too. I was like, well, I just started, and it wasn't with my company's name. I've said this before. I registered my company name first. It was one of the first investments I made in my business. But when I came up with really cool programs and online programs and online classes and speech titles, I waited to register those names because I was like, well, you know, who's going to steal these names? They're just starting out. It's our first year. People were coming for the names. They were coming for the names. So you want to think about if your name is original, you came up with it, you thought about it, no one else is using it, register it. Like, come on, have faith in your business. Register your business name. Now, number two, the second question that you want to ask is someone else using that business name already? And here's why I say this. Most people come up with a name, they come up with it, whatever, for whatever reason they come up with it, or they say God gave it to them or whatever. However you come up with your business name, your brilliant business ideas, they come up with the name, but they don't research that name to see if someone else is using it. And so we're going to talk through three things you can do to research your business name. Number one, search social media. Yes. Yes, Jackie. I'm super glad that we got started with your name. Search social media. Okay. So search social media, search Facebook, search Twitter, search Instagram, see if someone has any of those handles, search Google. So social media is number one. The first place you're going to search to see if anyone else is using your name is going to be social media. Okay. After you do a social media search, which is easy, do a Google search and don't stop on the first page. Go all the way back, do a Google search. And then you want to do what's called a test search, T-E-S-S search. So you want to go to the USPTO.gov website. Under trademarks, click search. Now, where a lot of people get mixed up is they'll say the name of my company is Hair Extensions Galore, but the name of the company that's registered is Extensions Galore. It's a little bit different. I should be okay. No, you are not okay. You are not okay. If someone else, and this is why having a trademark lawyer do your search is so critical, because one of the things that I do, and I don't know how other trademark lawyers operate, but if I know that your name is already being used, I know that someone else is using it, we tell you as soon as we can after we do our full search. And what we'll do at that point is come up with some different options that you have for names that we think may get registered. And so we'll walk with you through that process. I've had several clients that I've had to kind of walk through that process. But if I don't think your name is going to get approved, I'm not going to take you on as a client. And if I don't think your name is going to get approved, I'm not going to just file it without you saying, okay, I don't care what the risks are. I don't care what the probability is. I want to get this filed. We're going to talk about it first. So you'll know what those risks are going into it. And so we have those conversations, but you want to do a search, a really, really thorough search. And we search everywhere, far and wide, because there are some common law uses that can kind of throw your application off. It's rare, but it can happen. So we want you to be prepared for all of that. And when I say common law usage, that means they've been using the name longer than you, but they don't have it registered. So there are some situations that can come up like that as well. So is someone else using your business name? Have you checked? If you have not checked, you don't know. So you definitely want to make sure that you've checked that out. That's something that you want to do. Okay, so I'm getting a comment saying, I need your help. My trademark was denied. Okay. hit me up, send me a DM. We'll definitely talk about that. So if you've gone through this process on your own, it didn't work out, then send me a message and I'm happy to help you with that as well. And we'll just do a consultation. And the links to do a consult is on Instagram. It's in my bio. On Facebook, the link is right here for you all to just click on it. Very easy. So the third question you want to ask is your name catchy? Now look, the number one goal of a business is to make money. Like that is the number. I mean, I don't know. I can't say the goal of you. The number one goal of the for-profit corporations that I run is to make money. We want to do it ethically. We want to get income in. And the reality of it is, you all may have heard my philosophy on this before, but if you don't have income in, it's hard to say you're having impact out, right? So if I'm not making money, it's hard for me to hire people and make an impact. It's hard for me to help as many people as I want to make an impact. So for those of you who are very socially minded and you're like, it's not about money, it's about impact. Okay, well, good luck making big impact with absolutely no money. I don't know how that works. Maybe some of you are great and you can do that. But the number one goal of your business probably is to be profitable so that you can have the impact that you want on your community, on everybody else. So your name needs to be catchy. And when I say catchy, I mean, what is your customer's response to your business name? What is your customer's response to your business name? A lot of people come to me to get their trademarks done because they're like, girl, I went to this event. It was so good. It was amazing. And people's responses when I said my business name was like, that name is so catchy. It's so easy to remember. I love that name. That is such a good name to use. And they're like, it made them think, uh-oh, people are going to remember this. What if they register it before me? What if they copy my business name? And all of those things can happen, especially if you don't have it registered. Because even if you use it first, the federal government will look at who filed the trademark application first. Okay? And when I say the federal government, I mean specifically the USPTO office when they're reviewing trademarks. So it's all good and well to say, you know, I've been using this name for the past 5 years. But if you don't have a trademark, you don't own the business name. So let me explain the difference. I own a business when I file, really when I start doing business, right? And I could do business under my name. So, but when I file my paperwork with the state, they have you file like LLC paperwork and all that type of stuff, okay? So when the state has me file LLC paperwork for my business name, what a lot of people think is that because they have that document saying that they are the owners of the LLC in their state, they own that name nationwide and no one else can copy them. And that is simply not true. You can own a business and not own the brand assets affiliated with that business. Think of it like this. When I first started Speak Your Way to Cash as a podcast, I didn't own speakyourwaytocash.com. So I own Speak Your Way to Cash as a business. It's set up in my state. But I didn't own the domain for that business, which is a brand asset of the business. The same goes with the trademark. Now, the trademark is pending for Speak Your Way to Cash and Forget the Tea on Trademarks and all of my other stuff and the Currency of Confidence. I have a few trademark pendings now for my brand because I wanted to own all of the brand assets affiliated with my companies, okay? So think about that. Think about that. If your name is catchy, your customers have an amazing response to your business name, they can repeat it, that means you're building brand equity. Now, you're not really building brand equity if you started a business, no one knows about it, no one remembers your business name, they don't know what your name is called. That's not building brand equity. But if you have a name that is really building brand equity, it's out there, you have social media presence, you are in the names of whoever your ideal client is, corporations or individuals, they can repeat that name. You're sending out documents with that name on it. You're doing your email sales with that name on it, all that great stuff. Then you're building brand equity, okay? And you want to protect that. So you can own the business and not own the brand asset, not own the name for it. Now, here's what's crazy. Someone else that you know could see that you have this amazing business going, you have this great business name, and now they do the search on your business name, and they look up and they realize you don't own it. And let me tell you something, people are bold, okay? I am an attorney from one of the finest law schools in this here country, and I've had people try to beat me to the punch and register my name. I've had people copy my name. I've had, like, all the things that I warn you all about at this point in my business, 1 year of full-time entrepreneurship in, I've had people do these things to me. And then what I got to do? Got to go after them. You just have to, because you don't build up your brand equity. You don't get yourself on, I've been on television saying the names of my companies. I've been everywhere. You don't do all of that so that someone else can just steal your stuff. Now, here's the real though. When I first had someone do something like this to me and take a name that I had used for my business, it was so infuriating, humiliating, because I am a lawyer. I should have done this a long time ago. I should have protected my stuff. But it was also, I felt really attacked and I felt scared because I was like, oh, I already know how much this is going to cost to resolve this. And it was just the worst feeling in the world. So I know it's hard to imagine someone stealing your business name and it's hard to imagine how it'll make you feel, but I've been there. And even though I am an attorney and I knew how to handle it and I knew what to do and I knew how to put them dogs on them, I still was just petrified that I even had to go through that process. So it's not a process you want to go through. So three signs you need to change your business name. If your name is not original, consider changing it. Like if you have a Apple store and the name of your business is Apple, it's the worst. Like that's not going to get it. It's hard to get that approved. It's probably not building brand equity. It's too generic, right? Ashley says it makes you feel violated when people steal your stuff. Absolutely. Absolutely, you feel violated. And there was a part of me that was like, I could just let this go. Like, whatever. Just let them have it. But then I talked to my husband. I talked to my dad. And they were like, get after her. And I was like, well, I'm going to have to sue. So, you know, you do what you have to do. But I know how it feels to be like, oh, whatever. I could just let this go. I don't have time for this. But the reality is at some point you do have to fight for your stuff. Now, to avoid all of that fight, and I could have avoided all of that fight by as soon as I came up with something that I knew was going to stick in the marketplace, right? And what do I mean by stick in the marketplace? I knew, so when I did Get the Tea on Trademarks, the first time I did it was like 9 months ago. That's my DIY trademarking class to teach people how to file their own trademarks for $250 versus them paying me $2,000, which is the cost of doing it through our firm. Every single month I was doing that class live, I had people in the class every single month, new people every single month. Even now the class is on autopilot, you can now take it whenever you want. Every single month we have people buying the class. So I knew, like, obviously once you start getting money for something under a certain name, you know that name is viable. I could see if you're sitting at home, like nobody's bought anything from you all year, whatever, whatever. You don't think it's going to sell. But once it's been validated by the market, protect it. Of course people are. I mean, you already know people are going to buy it. So protect your stuff. So I could have avoided that. That was totally my fault. And I say that because I'm putting myself out there like that to let y'all know having the knowledge isn't enough. You have to take the action. And if you're not going to do all the things you need to do to learn the trademarking process and intellectual property process, then you need to hire a lawyer, preferably me, to help you handle this thing, because this is what we do all day. Like, I wake up thinking about this stuff. You all don't. Like I've been very public about my mistakes the first year in business, one of which was waiting to hire a bookkeeper. So now, you know, I have this awesome bookkeeper and I'll tell you, like, she wakes up thinking about books, like thinking about entries and all these different things. And whenever we have to talk about all of my little things that she can't reconcile on her own, I'm just like, oh, I hate this. You know what I mean? Like, this is not what I want to do. All I want to wake up, I want to sell, I want to do legal work. And so if legal is like bookkeeping and accounting to me for you, then you need to just hire me. Okay, so how do you get started? How do you get started? There's two ways you can do this, right? No surprise here. You can DIY the process. That means you can literally choose to file your own trademark. Now, I will say, and as you all saw, because these comments are public, this is not legal advice, it's just education. People have been commenting on this live on, you know, IG and other areas saying like, I tried doing it on my own, it didn't work. That happens. That happens, right? Now, I recommend you, if you cannot, now here's the thing. The best course of action is to hire an attorney. When I need legal work, even in the field of trademark law, I typically hire a lawyer first, another lawyer, even if they do trademark law, just because I am far more attentive to doing other people's legal work, and I'll put mine on the back burner. Like, oh, well, you know how it is. You know how it is. Like, if you service clients, you'll have attention to detail to your business and everything else, but what you love doing, what you get paid to do is service your clients. So if you're like that, hire it out. So how can you get started? But you can do it on your own. Now, I'd recommend you do it on your own if there's no way you could afford the $2,000 trademark fee to work with my firm and do it, right? So if you know you cannot afford to hire a lawyer, there's no way you can afford it. We do have a lawyer on layaway plan. We have payment options and all that great stuff. But even with all of that, if you're like, I just cannot do it. And when I say payment options, you'd be looking like you could, our system allows you to choose whether you pay weekly, biweekly, or monthly. You could do like 8 payments of $250 or however else you want to do it. But if you know, like, I can't even budget this in, then do it yourself. And why do I say do it yourself in that instance? I say do it yourself because it's better than you not being protected at all. And if you need help with doing it yourself, which you will, because it is not an easy process, it's not intuitive, then what you can do is take the Get the Tea on Trademarks class. And you can find that at gum.co/TONTM. That link is right up here on Facebook. It's on Instagram. You can also just DM me or type info below, and then I'll make sure I get you the link as well. The second option, the best option, the gold standard is to work with a lawyer. The trademarking process is a 9+ month process. Several of my clients have commented in the comments. We handle it. We handle it. Any correspondence from the government, we handle it. We respond to it. We keep you informed. We keep you updated. I'm about to go on vacation, but I'm emailing all my clients first, you know, making sure that they're up to date on what's happening with their marks. But it's a long process. It's a long process. Last week, I talked to several attorneys at the USPTO office about marks that I'm handling. And you, when you're negotiating with people and you're talking to them, you want to make sure you know the terminology, because let's say you do it on your own. That's fine. But the government has lawyers reviewing these applications. They aren't, you know, administrative workers that aren't barred. These are barred licensed attorneys that are reviewing these applications. Excuse me. So, gold standard, work with a lawyer. Work with a lawyer. DM me if you want your trademark done. If you tried doing it on your own and it didn't work, we can take over the process at that point and respond to the office action for you. Do a consult first. Do a consult first. That's going to help. And the consultation, you guys, new client, $99. It's like nothing. $99. It's not a lot when you think about the grand scheme of working and investing with your business. So in the class, Get the Tea on Trademarks, you'll learn how to file your own federally registered trademark application. You will actually see me filing a live fake application so you can see how the process works. And you'll register for that, as I said, at gum.co/TONTM. If you want to work with me, then you just go to mobilegeneralcounsel.com. But working with me starts with the consultation. It starts with the consult. I want to make sure we can help you. I want to make sure you're clear on what we're going to do for you. And then we can talk. It's good. We get to know each other from that vantage point as well. So that is really the way that that we can do this. But I hope that this was helpful. I'm seeing this was some good information, real jewels. Look, protect your stuff. Because just, look, we have to value the businesses that we're creating as though they are already billion-dollar brands. I was having a really stressful day, and I don't know what was going on, but when I found out this girl was trying to use my name or a similar name to mine, and I knew her, of course, petty, right? I was starting to have I was like stressed out about it, and I was talking to my husband, and then I was like, you know what, Chris? What would the billion-dollar version of me do? What would billionaire Ashley do? How would she handle this? And I was like, you know what? She would hire a lawyer. She would go about her day. She'd hire the best, and she wouldn't even worry about it. And that's what I did. I just hired someone to handle it. I mean, because at that point, if I can put some money on a problem and save me time, from my vantage point, time is more valuable than money. And because of that, I need to get my time back. I definitely need to get my time back. So you really want to figure out, instead of you getting emotional, getting upset, worrying about what's going to happen, protect your business on the front end. But if it's too late and you get a cease and desist, we help respond to those. Or you realize you're infringing on someone else's mark and you have to change your name, let's do a consult. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about your new name and make sure it's one that you can get behind, that you believe in, that works for you. But all right, guys, my name is Ashley Kirkwood, founder of Mobile General Counsel, also professional speaker. So founder of Speak Your Way to Cash. And on that note, if any of you are interested in booking more paid speaking engagements in 2020, we have the last Speak Your Way to Cash event of the year coming up on October 26th. So that's a whole nother story. But if you have questions about that, let me know. Otherwise, I will see you guys later. And hopefully you enjoyed the video. Please share it with your friends, tag an entrepreneur who needs to see this. I appreciate you guys joining in, and I'll talk to you guys soon.